What's going on, everybody? See here. Welcome back to some more No Man's Sky. So, last episode, we got some things done. We got some things built. Now, I did stream since then. I did a stream on YouTube and I did a stream on Twitch. If you caught the stream on YouTube, awesome. You can still catch it. It's just check my videos. You'll check it live streams or whatever. And I streamed on Twitch as well. If you missed the stream on Twitch, it's all right. You didn't miss a whole lot. We did some grindy stuff. Anyways, we got to start with the grindy stuff that we did because I got to show it off. It's fantastic. And I know I'm going to get questions. Also, I need to go to the Nexus, actually, so we can get some more base pieces and base parts. So yeah, we're going to be doing some upgrading. We're going to be doing some building. We're going to be doing a whole bunch of fun things. Hopefully you guys enjoy. If you do, make sure you leave a like. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe as well for some more. Now, another question that I have for all of you. Please comment and let me know. Do you want to see the storyline of the game as we play it, or are you here more for upgrades and exploring and things like that? Because if I do storyline, I'm just trying to figure out if I need to include the storyline in my videos, or if that's not really what you're here for. You want to see some other stuff. You know what I mean? Because the storyline, once you've done it once, you kind of done it like, you know, 100 times essentially. So just leave a comment below. Let me know. Do you want story? Story, no story. Let me know. All right. Oh, what is that? Wait. What are you? Why are you holding a pistolio? Request dialect help. They present the data pad doing a list of words. Corvax symbol. You've learned the core. I've learned the Corvax word for Corvax. Oh, wonderful. That's so good. Okay, we gotta go to the Nexus. And then we gotta go and sell some stuff because we gotta make some monies. Yeah, so we're just having a good time. We're having a good time. All right, so I'm here to go and get some more base pieces unlocked. I did a little bit of salvage research gathering. It's, you know, super exciting and fun. Not really. So we're gonna spend that research data and we're gonna try to unlock some things. All right, so construction research station. What are the things that I needed? I would like to get another storage deal. I'm honestly thinking the antimatter reactor could be pretty handy. And I'd like to kind of see how it works. That's gonna take 20 of them. That's fine. That's fine. Let's get that guy. New blueprint learned. Okay, let's see, what else do we have? Ooh, short range teleport would be really nice too. Let's go ahead and get the short range teleport. Let's make that happen. Okay, and then let's go ahead and get a save beacon unlocked too, because that's almost a necessity too. Now, do I want vehicles? I don't know that I want vehicles yet. And I don't really care about decorative stuff right now either. I'm more worried about the functional things. Gas extractor. That would probably be pretty good. I've never actually messed with the gas extractor, but I think that could be fun. Hydroponic stuff, if we want to grow plants, we're going to need all that. You know, I'm thinking that the storage units are probably going to be like the big deal here. I think we should probably get storage units. I could get, let's see, what these are, all five apiece. Wait, I might be able to get all of them. Wait. Let's get as many as we can. But I want to get them in order. I don't want to get like 1, 4, and 7 or whatever it is. What is it? 1, 4. Yeah, I don't want to get 1, 4, and 7. I want to get 1, 2, 3, then 4. Oh goodness. You know, I actually had enough to get all of them. That's amazing. That is fantastic. Okay, so I have 10 salvage data left. Let's see. What do we want here? Now, I'm not a huge fan of the pre-built rooms anymore. I really like the cuboid rooms. I think the cuboid rooms are a little bit more fun. But these rooms do have their purpose. Huh. You know what? Let's get the gas extractor. I got 10 left. Let's just get the gas extractor. I've never played with it, but it might be handy. I don't know. We'll have to see. Okay, cool. So we got all that stuff. We got a ton of blueprints. That is super handy. I don't have a lot of nanites. I did find a place that has nanites, and I did mark it as a base, but it's honestly a terrible planet. So we might try to find a new one. But let's go. How's my inventory look now? Okay, good. It's clear, clean and clear. Let's go and grab some activated indium. That's right. If you missed the live stream, we went out, we found a planet that had activated indium. And not only did we find the planet, we found a spot and we found a spot that was actually next to a power source as well. So activated indium site alpha, that's what I named it. I don't know, I should have just named it like Z1 activated indium mine or something. I don't know, anyways. So we have that. Let's go check this out. All right, so we are here. As you see, I have a nice little base set up. I have a teleporter, all that fun stuff. So it is an extreme hazard planet. Now, activated indium, activated copper, activated any resource is usually on a terrible, horrible, awful planet. So this is my mine right here. I have, I think I have 8 miners on it, and I have a bunch of storage because storage is honestly the issue. Because I don't really care how fast it's being mined, but you can see right here that we have 14 minutes left until it's completely full, and we have 40,000 activated indium. And we have a transfer rate of 2840 per hour. So to give you an idea, we had 40,000. This one stack right here is worth 9 million units. So you can see how much money we actually have right here and how amazing it is. So this is literally where I'm going to be getting all my units from. You know what? Let's just go back and sell it. Let's just sell it. That's literally all I came here for, was to grab that and sell it anyways. Okay, so now we're just gonna wait for somebody to sell. Now, if you're looking for activated indium, you're gonna have to try to find, you're gonna have to get to a blue star system. So indium and activated indium are on blue star systems. Cadmium, activated cadmium was on red. Emerald and activated emerald are gonna be on green. Those are like the planetary specific like resources. So you're gonna have to get to a blue system, which means you're either gonna have to have your drive upgraded, or you're gonna have to have like portal glyphs to portal to one, which I don't have portal glyphs yet. Or you're gonna have to have a buddy that's on one, and then hopefully they can bring you with them to that place. But yeah, you have to find a blue system, scan it, and look for activated indium on the planet, and that's how you're gonna find that. So again, if you missed the live stream, we did it all in the live stream. It was a fantastically good time, had a blast. And then we also did live stream over on Twitch. So if you want to, you can head over to twitch.tv/z1gaming. You can catch me live stream over there twice a week. So yeah. Actually, you know what? While we're here waiting, did I grab the upgrade from here? I probably did. I need to start warping. Hello. And I need to start getting my suit upgrades. So you can see I got a couple suit upgrades. Nothing amazing yet. I do want to go through and get all of them. However, they're very expensive once you get more and more of them. And I think they cap out at like 5 million a piece. So that's why we wanted to make money. But this is going to be how I'm making money forever. So if you ever see my units, that's how I made my money. Hello there, good sir. Have I got the deal for you? I know you were looking for activated indium, and I got you hooked up. I got you the hookup. Sell items. And activated indium, 35,812,000. And that's a negative 6.2% too. So like I could go somewhere else and get a little bit more, but I really don't care. It's not worth it. That is, look at that. Look at, we're at 76 million units. This is amazing. It's amazing. Awesome. All right, so let's head back to the base. I want to do a little bit of base building, and I'm actually been kind of torn because the planet that I'm on, it is a paradise planet, but it's like a red paradise planet. I don't like the look of it. So I'm trying to think if maybe we should find, why is that like an Ethernet jack right there? Are we all really tiny? Is that like the size of an actual Ethernet port? Maybe we're like ants running around. That would, everything would make sense. So yeah, I'm trying to think if we want to, you know what? Let's go back to our base. Let's build the antimatter reactor. I want to see how that works. And we'll go from there. Okay, I want to build that antimatter reactor thing, but I have to build it. I need two antimatter, so we need chromatic metal and carbon, dense carbon. Do I not have chromatic metal? Oh, we got copper right here. Let's get that transferred over. Let's turn that into chromatic metal, which actually reminds me, I need to go check out my copper mine so I get that more chromatic metal being made. Now, the reason I want chromatic metal so bad is because it's super useful. And when you get a living ship, chromatic metal is actually used as the warp fuel. So it's so much cheaper. Well, to me, it's cheaper and easier. Okay. So that's doing that thing. We need condensed carbon. I guess I'll just get carbon around here. Why not? All right, perfect. So I think we needed two of these. And I think that's it. I think we have everything else we need. So let's go to tech. I'm guessing general antimatter reactor. Let's go ahead and put this. Can we just like squeeze it right here in between? Yeah. Okay. So what do you even do? So I have to put, wait, what? Generator coupling, chargeable power unit. The generator coupling is an important piece of the machine's rechargeable power system. Without it, the generator would fruitlessly spin, pumping power out into the void. Wait, why do I have to charge it? Wait. Why can't I just hook it into my base and get it for free? Antimatter reactor. Uncontained usage is not recommended. Okay, so what if I put... So is it make fuel the generator antimatter? Fuel the reactor to generate antimatter. How long does it take? I better get a lot off this because, I mean, it's carbon and chromatic metal. Oh wow, we got one off of 95%. Okay, all right, I'll be quiet. We'll just let it run, we'll let it do its thing. Okay, so what I'm thinking is, I'm gonna let this run and do its thing because I wanna try to find our planet. I wanna try to find our planet that we're gonna call home and where we're gonna be actually living, because I don't wanna build too big of a base on this planet. It's too red. The red water, the red ground, everything's red. It just doesn't make for good screenshots. It doesn't make for very scenic areas, you know? I'm not a huge fan. It is a paradise planet technically, but I could go for a more blue and green lush looking regular Earth-like planet. So I wanna go out and look, but we are gonna need a bunch of antimatter because we're gonna be warping around quite a bit. And then in all actuality, we need to swap back to our other ship. So I picked up this ship because it was like super huge. But we're actually gonna swap back to, let's see. No, I wanna summon a different one. I wanna summon you because you're the one with the upgraded drives, so we can go to any system that we want to. So now I want to go try to find a planet. I want to try to find a planet that we're going to call home. That's the goal. Let's see. Okay, primary switch ship changed. Now, I do have some hyperdrive fuel, warp cell, or warp hypercore. A warp hypercore would be nice, because I think that like is a one-time refuel thing. But I don't think we can make that right now. And then I guess I better go ahead and start making up some antimatter housings. Oxygen ferrite dust. You know, we did actually unlock the, we did unlock that gas thing. No gases nearby. Darn. Cause I wouldn't mind checking out what kind of gases we could get. Like if we could get oxygen from a gas thing, that would be kind of cool. Okay. So we have a gas cloud. Potential A. But what is it? What kind of gas do we have here? It's oxygen. Oh my gosh. That would actually be like super handy. Can we build here? I could throw up a little base deal right here to get some oxygen. Okay, let's do this. Let's make this happen. Oh my gosh, I never even thought about that, because oxygen is used for like everything. So going to get in a stack of oxygen every now and then, that would be super handy. Okay, so I don't think I'm gonna have nearly the stuff to do this, but we're gonna put it right here. We're gonna make a nice little spot right there and right there. Fantastic. Okay, so let's see what a gas extractor is gonna cost us. Mineral extractor, gas extractor. Okay, one there. Supply depot. I need some metal plating. That's not bad. What about power? We're gonna have to go solar. Electromagnetic generator. We don't have a power spot over here, unfortunately. I don't think. I mean, we could look. No. There's another hotspot over here too. I'm not gonna worry about it. Okay, so no power. Let me call my ship in here. Which ship do I have that has the stuff? Okay, so it's not that one. It's actually, I need to summon you. I think that one has gold on it, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it has gold. Okay, cool. And I should be able to build from it, right? Yeah, I just gotta make metal plating. Okay, easy enough. Okay, so let's go ahead. Let's put a... you know what? Let's put a supply depot down real quick. We'll do that. And we'll just get these connected like that. So that way they can at least be some kind of storage. And let's go to power this. I need to make another metal plating. Probably need to make like two or three of these bad boys, but I meant to do more than one at a time. Ooh, I'm out of ferrite dust? No way. Oh, that's terrible. That is awful. Okay, so there's three of those. Do I have battery stuff? Oh, I do. I can build two. All right, well, let's build two. And let's get everything wired up and connected here. There's those. Go ahead and go into there. We'll just go there to there. And we'll go there to there. Is it working? 412 per hour. Ooh! That's not bad. We just need more storage. That way when I'm running low on like oxygen, like a stack of oxygen, I just come over here and grab it. Now, how much are we storing with this? 1250? So I'd like to build like 8 or 9 of these guys, because like I said, I'd like to be able to grab just a full stack in case I need it for anything. So sidetracked, making oxygen now. That's fantastic. Are these charging up good? 50 KPU, 75 available. Okay, cool. So one solar panel is just generating power for the batteries. That's good. Let's go grab some ferrite dust and let's get some more storage on here. Oh my gosh, I love setting up these mining outpost things, because this is the only one of these I'm ever gonna need, and I'll be good to go, because I can just come back here, grab oxygen. Oh, it's so handy. Actually, before we leave, let's change the name of this to the oxygen. All right, let's get a couple more of these in here. I'm probably not gonna get like a whole stack's worth of in here, just because like I don't really want to expand this too big, and I want to make sure I'm actually gonna use it first. You know what I mean? Okay, so let's see. Let's go to industry supply depot, and I'm just gonna try to run like a chain of them this way behind it. How many I can build? 3. All right, let's do that, and then let's just get them all connected up. Boom, boom. No. No, that was not right. Whatever. I don't even care. I don't care. It is what it is. Okay, so how much can we store now? What are we looking at? 5250. That's not bad. That's not bad. We'll just leave it with that. We'll let the oxygen do its thing. Heck yes, we can warp back here. We can't warp away because I don't have a teleporter hooked up here, but that's fine. Because I have another base like right over there. Yes, we got a base right there, so it's like it's not even super far. So let's go back. Let's check on our antimatter. And let's get some antimatter stuff made, and then let's start looking for a new planet. Excuse me, Mr. Antimatter Reactor, how many do you have for me? 20? Oh, that's amazing. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Craft product. I should be able to make 10 of these. Oh my gosh, that is amazing. How many of these can I make? Can I make 10 more? No way. We have 20 warp cells. Oh, that is fantastic. I don't think we can make the warp cores yet either. Oh my gosh, that is amazing. Okay. Now I actually need to switch to my other ship, because my other ship has the has all the drives in it. So we can actually go to every system that we need to. I wish I had the economy scanner on here, but I don't. So it is what it is. Let's look for a planet, shall we? This just in. We've got a freighter that's under attack. This might actually be my freighter that I'm gonna get for free. And it's actually kind of cool looking. It's kind of neato. Let's go ahead. Let's do this. Come on, boys. I gotta rescue this freighter so I can get my first free freighter. Okay, how many more do we have left? Oh, I got another one. We're going in. I got you. Okay, I think, got some more. Come on, bud. I could use a free freighter. Are we good? Oh, fantastic. Let me guess. We're gonna get a call here, and we're going to get... Yeah, you want me to come aboard your ship and check it out? In communication. You know what? I'll take it. I will take it. It's a free one. All right. And actually, it actually doesn't look that bad. It's kind of cool looking. I can't lie. It's actually kind of neato. Wait, where am I supposed to be going here? Okay, I don't care. Thank you. Where's the ship? Is that not it? Oh, it's this little dinky thing up here? Oh, no. No, 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 no. If it was this one, maybe. Not that little dinky thing. I don't want it. I don't want it. Well, it is free, though. I wanted this one. This one looks so much better. I guess let's just go look. Let's check it out. Man, I was actually kind of excited for that one. But no, it's this little nasty thing that we got here. Oh, so teeny tiny. You know what, though? I can't complain too much. I can always swap it out later. At least this way I'll have one. My ships will be on it. It'll be fine. We just won't do anything to it. Hello there, sir. Let me guess. You want me to relieve you of command? That's fine. Inspect freighter. I mean, it's free. It's a B-class, 19 slots. It's not bad. It's not bad. It's super dinky, though. Like, this is like this little chubbiest little tiny thing ever. Let's accept it. That's fine. It's a B-class. I can't complain. Thank you. Look at that. Freighter fleets. Yeah. Okay, I have a freighter. We got a free freighter, guys. Wonderful. That's not really what I was here for. I wanted to scan the planets to see if we could find a paradise planet. And look, all my ships now have a home. Any cool ships in here? That one's kind of neat right there. I'm not going to lie. And it's gone. So while we're in the system, no paradise planets, but in the systems that I go to, I'm going to go to the space station and the Nexus to get suit upgrades or storage slot expansions. And I'm going to check to see if they have any, good S-class modules for my suit. So we have shield module. Oh, that actually would be really good. That would actually be really good. Underwater protection, don't care. Shield module, though, that's kind of a big deal. Thank you, we'll take that. And then movement module, stuff like that. I'm not going to buy anything unless it's S-class now. Because we have a way to get nanites with the larval cores anyways. So, let's see. Where is S-class shield module? Let's go ahead and install that technology. Put that right there. Do we not have a regular shield? Am I missing this thing? I guess not. Core health 33%, shield strength 82%, core health 33%. Heck yes, looking good. Thank you, sir. And I don't think we need anything else. I don't really want to do. Oh my gosh, what the heck? It's a C class. That's a cool looking. I like it though. It looks good. Okay, we're not taking it. We're not taking it. Oh, there's another black and red living ship. Oh, it looks so good. It looks so good. I cannot wait. Don't worry. Once we get enough Quicksilver for a living ship. Actually, there's another Quicksilver mission that I have available. Once we get enough Quicksilver for a living ship, I will be making an episode on actually getting the living ship and how to get them. But then once we get the one we get for free, or we don't get it for free. The first one you get. After that, you can go back and try to get the ones that you actually want. I'll be making a video on that too. So that's coming. Living ship is coming, I promise. Well, we're getting closer. Everything's not red, but everything's orange now. So we're still not quite there. And I usually like to move the sun right above head. Well, hold on. Right above me. So that way I can actually see the true colors of everything. It's like, yeah, still not, it's still not quite there. But I think what we're going to do is I think I'm actually going to end the episode there because it's going to take me a little bit to find the perfect planet. I found a few planets that were almost perfect, except that either the Sentinels were like aggressive or there was like storms that were like superheated or, you know, we want to find like the perfect planet. I want to find one with the right color scheme with no storms, or like the storm as a gentle breeze or something like that is whatever it's called, with few Sentinels. So basically the planet I found last time was, geez, that was like actually like a really good planet. So I'm gonna look around for a while, and as I go I am getting upgrades for my suit. So you can see I kind of filled out some here. I think I got another cargo, and I think I got another technology slot. So I'm gonna get those started filling out. Eventually I'm gonna start running low on money though, so But yes, that's going to end this episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure you leave a like if you're new here. Don't forget to subscribe as well for some more. And hopefully next episode, I'll have a planet. Either that or I'll just say, okay, we're just going to go back to the planet that I was at before. And we'll just wait till we get some portal coordinates and do that route. But yes, thank you again for coming out. Have a fantastic rest of your day, and I will see you in the next one.
Bye, everybody.